Welcome my dear students of class 10 to my history revision class. Today's chapter Mahatma Gandhi and Mahatma Gandhi and the National Movement, chapter number 6. I am revising this lesson for your better understanding. The points which I will revise, I shall discuss. Please try to understand it. If you have any problem, let me know later. Now, you know Mahatma Gandhi, who became one of the most important political leaders of India. He adopted the policy of Satyagraha. He was the first leader of India, adopted a new technique and new method and applied it in his practical life and achieved success. Who was he? He was the father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi. Now, what technique and method had he adopted? He adopted the policy of Satyagraha. Satyagraha means non-violent method. Non-violent method of resistance means basic resistance, non-violent method. He adopted and he used it as weapon against the British and achieved success. The Satyagraha is nothing but an idea of, you know, or a concept of Gandhiji. He gained it while fighting against the Indians in South Africa, because in South Africa Gandhiji went and fought against the racial discrimination, and he succeeded in course of time. South Indian government, the white ruler of South India, they were compelled to accept the minimum demands of Gandhiji there. So Gandhiji came back to India with great courage and confidence, and ultimately he adopted the same technique, same method in India also, the policy of Satyagraha. So what is the meaning of policy of Satyagraha? Satyagraha means truth. Satyagraha means truth without giving into any pressure, and it was against the violence. That means it was a non-violent method of protest. It was a non-violent method of protest followed by Gandhiji. This is known as Satyagraha. And what is non-violence? You know, Gandhiji believed that non-violence means ahimsa. In Hindi term, ahimsa, greatest power, as it gives the people to use a moral victory and to stand up a bully without fear and anger, defeats the opponent completely. And the strength of non-violence lies in person's courage to endure anything for truth. Ultimately, Gandhiji succeeded in course of time. He advocated the use of indigenously manufactured products in India. Why? Because the Indian artisan and craftsmen failed to earn money from their indigenous industry because of the British manufactured goods which were coming from England and captured, flooded the large market of India. Its prices were very less, quality also was superior. Naturally, many of their goods were purchased by Indian people. But Gandhiji tried to make them understand the drawbacks of it. He favored Indian artisans and Indian craftsmen so that they could earn better money facing the competition with the British. But the British manufactured goods did not want to leave one inch of land for them. They kept on occupying the large market of India by supplying their finished products, their productive goods, which were produced through machines, and Indian artisans and Indian craftsmen were totally dependent on their handmade goods, which were done manually. there was no system of system of production through machines like English manufactured books. Naturally, they could not compete with them, but Gandhiji favored them. As a result, Gandhiji started the Swadeshi movement. He encouraged the people of India to use only Swadeshi products. He requested the people of India to boycott foreign goods, foreign products. He also conducted bonfire. He encouraged the people of India that Swadeshi goods would bring social justice, would bring economic prosperity in the country. So this was nothing but Gandhian policy of philosophy, just achieve success. And ultimately, he was able to get the the mass involved in his national movement. How? By encouraging them to be the member of his, to join the movement under his leadership. A number of Indian people came forward, especially the educated one. They came forward and supported Gandhiji's stand. Why? Educated people, why did educated people come and join Gandhiji? Because educated people had no promotion in the British administration. They are appointed as appointed officials in the British administration, but in spite of having their qualities, they could not have a promotion like the Europeans or like the Britishers. Number one, and number two, a very less number of Indian educated people appointed in British administration. Naturally, they felt insulted, and many of them, they left the jobs under the Britishers and joined Indian national movement under the leadership of Gandhiji. So some factors also are there which, forced Gandhiji to start some movement in India. That was, Montagu Chelmsford reforms or Government of India Act of 1919. August Declaration made, a situation. One movement was started, that was Home Rule Movement. Home Rule Movement was started only because of the reason of Montagu Chelmsford reform. The Montagu Chelmsford reform encouraged Indian rulers, Indian politicians to start a new movement, that was Home Rule Movement. Who started it? It was started by Bal Gangadhar Tilak. The Home Rule Movement. They demanded home rule in India, but the Britishers requested them not to utter the term Swaraj. The British considered the term Swaraj to be seditious. That's why he requested Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Bal Gangadhar, please don't use the term Swaraj. Use the term home rule, but don't utter the term Swaraj, because we don't like it. As a result, Bal Gangadhar Tilak started home rule, and the British gave them a number of privileges. And another follower of Bal Gangadhar Tilak, who was she was a lady from Ireland, an Irish lady. Who was she? She was Annie Besant. Annie Besant also followed the footsteps of Bal Gangadhar Tilak and also established another home rule movement from South India. But ultimately, home rule movement was declined. In today's live class, I discussed that point. Some students could not answer prominently. Please listen to me perfectly. Why was the Home Rule Movement declined in India? The Home Rule Movement, which was started by Bal Gangadhar Tilak, it was and later Annie Besant, it was declined due to long absence of Bal Gangadhar Tilak. Bal Gangadhar Tilak went to England and stayed there for many years. So the long absence of Bal Gangadhar Tilak and the moral support and lack of moral support from Bal Gangadhar Tilak from abroad resulted in the declination of that very movement, Home Rule movement in India. Mahatma Gandhi, started a new movement that was non-cooperation movement. Now, why did he start the non-cooperation movement? There are certain factors behind it, my dear students, Number one, Rowlatt Act, passing of Rowlatt Act. Second, the Khilafat issue. Third, Jallianwala Bagh incident. Now, what is Rowlatt Act? Rowlatt Act was one act. Rowlatt Act was an act passed by the British in the year 1919 to give it was passed by the British in order to provide, in order to arrest the Indian revolutionaries without trial and conviction in a court of law. This act was declared Black Act by the people of India. There were demonstrations, hartals and strikes all over the India under the leadership of Gandhiji. And finally, the people of India decided to, decided to start a movement against the British, and they were thinking to start it. Meanwhile, another important golden opportunity came before Gandhiji to avail. What was it? At the end of the First World War, Turkey was defeated at the hands of the Allied powers and suffered humiliation at the hands of Britain. But the ruler of Turkey was their religious head. So the Muslims had great respect for their religious head. And whenever their religious head was humiliated at the hands of Britain or England or at the Allies after the First World War, the people of the Muslims of the world, they felt insulted. And in India, the Muslims also decided to organize a new movement against against their religious practices, because the religious customs and tradition, what they had been practicing, it was against that very system. That's why the Muslims of India started a new movement that was Khilafat movement in order to protest against the system of the British government. Gandhiji saw that it was a golden opportunity for him, because relationship between the two communities of India, Hindu and Muslims, was strained. So he decided to strengthen the unity between the two communities by supporting the Khilafat issue. Gandhiji strongly supported the Khilafat movement, and later on another incident took place in India, that was Jallianwala Bagh massacre. The two famous, Punjabi leaders, Dr. Saifuddin and Dr. Saifuddin Kichlu and Dr. Satyapal were arrested. Dr. Satyapal and Dr. Saifuddin Kichlu were arrested while demonstrating and meeting in Punjab. But in protest against their arrest, the people of Punjab, the Congress leaders of Punjab, conducted a meeting at Jallianwala Bagh, a place near a park, and there was a very narrow entrance of that very park, where a number of children, number of women, old age people, all group of people joined there in order to attend the meeting. It was, General Dyer, the military commander of Jallianwala Bagh, forbade the people of Jallianwala Bagh from attending the meeting, but no one heard him. People of all classes, they attended the meeting. So he felt very much insulted. He grew offended. Jayar, along with his soldiers, entered the park and ordered his troops to open fire on the unarmed gatherings. Thousands of people died and many of them were killed. That incident came just like a reign of terror, but General Dyer had no regrets for that, and ultimately a number of Indian personalities felt insulted. It was Rabindranath Tagore who gave up his knighthood award, and it was due to the efforts of Mahatma Gandhi. A new movement was started in protest against the Jallianwala Bagh massacre, Rowlatt Act, and Khilafat issue, the non-cooperation movement. So once Mahatma Gandhi supported the Khilafat movement, in return for it, the Muslims, mean the two Ali brothers, Maulana Muhammad Ali and Maulana Shaukat Ali, strongly supported Gandhiji's non-cooperation movement. Gandhiji decided to non-cooperate with the British. Gandhiji encouraged the people of India to leave British jobs, to leave British schools, British colleges. He also requested Indian educated people to leave British jobs. The legal practitioners left their legal jobs. Doctors left their, practice. Teachers left their teaching profession. So everywhere, the people of India started non-cooperating with the British. Gandhiji also decided to non-cooperate with the British in a peaceful way. Gandhiji decided to spoil the entire system of administrative structure, because Gandhiji realized that without the cooperation of India, the British could not run a smooth governance in our country, India. So no smooth governance is possible without the cooperation of the Indians. So in order to stop the entire administrative system in India, Gandhiji adopted the policy of non-cooperation, and the non-cooperation movement, became a movement of India. People of different parts of India, they cooperated, they joined Gandhiji's non-cooperation movement and started non-cooperating the British and British administration. This non-cooperation movement, brought a remarkable change in the entire system of British administration. Gandhiji launched his first nationwide Satyagraha on 1st August 1920. During that time, the day Tilak died, it was the first mass movement under the leadership of Gandhiji. Now, what are the objectives of the Gandhiji's non-cooperation movement? The spirit of the movement was a practical application of Ahimsa based on Gandhiji's principles of passive resistance. Gandhiji simply introduced certain systems to be followed. As a result, the Muslim League joined the movement. It became a pan-Indian movement that managed to shake the British administration into a repressive frenzy that further antagonized the Indian population. And ultimately, what happened during this movement? As I mentioned earlier, a number of people left their jobs, lawyers, doctors, engineers, teachers, they all left their jobs. Khadi became a new symbol of self-reliance and nationalism. At the Nagpur session of the Congress, in the year 1920, Gandhiji and his program of non-cooperation was overwhelmingly supported by millions of people. 14,000 delegates were there who strongly supported Gandhiji's non-cooperation movement at the Nagpur session of the Congress in the year 1920. Jinnah sought in vain to cozen against extreme measures and finally quit the Congress in disgust. The popularity of the Congress was going on increasing. As a result, Jinnah realized that it was going against the interests of the Muslims. Immediately, he quit the Congress in disgust. And besides, people boycotted government functions, government offices, government schools, government British products, British goods. People boycotted elections. People boycotted entire administrative system of the British and British policies. People use only Swadeshi products. Spinning khadi became a national symbol of the country. Charka, national symbol of the country. The British reacted strongly. The British felt that something was happening in the country which was favoring the Indian people against the British. So there should have been a strong policy of the Britishers through which they could check the growing influence of the political leaders, especially Gandhiji. That's why the government reacted with repressive measures. A number of people were arrested in prison on various charges of sedition and anti-national activities. Throughout the whole country, the government made an attempt to arrest a number of people. The controlled anger of the people formed the non-cooperation movement to be the movement of the mass, to movement of the people. But ultimately, suddenly, that movement came to an end. Under what circumstances? A group of people became violent at Chowri Chowra, a place near Gorakhpur in Uttar Pradesh, where the aggressive people attacked the police station and 22 policemen were killed. They set fire to the police station. 22 policemen were working there during midnight. So they all were killed by the aggressive villagers of Chowri Chowra village. And then the news of non-violence movement, the policy of non-violence method of Satyagraha, which was the motto and ideals of Gandhiji's movement, suddenly it became violent. When the news reached Gandhiji, he felt very much sorry and decided to withdraw the non-cooperation movement. Because Gandhiji's movement was based on non-violent method of Satyagraha. But whenever that movement became violent, Gandhiji realized that immediately it should be withdrawn. That's why he withdrew the non-cooperation movement. As a result of it, a number of Indian political leaders were offended. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel, Sarojini Naidu, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, they all were imprisoned. And while in jail, they all protested against the decision of Gandhiji's withdrawal of non-cooperation movement. They openly, Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose said, when the movement is at on its climax, the movement should not have been withdrawn. But Gandhiji withdrew it. It was a great mistake of Gandhiji, quoted by Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. And Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru also was with him. He also strongly supported it. And ultimately, a number of political parties also started establishing under the leadership of Motilal Nehru, father of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, under the leadership of Deshbandhu Chittaranjan Das, under the leadership of Rajendra Prasad, a new political party was established, the Swaraj Party. But Rajendra Prasad did not get himself involved directly in that party, because he was also a lawyer. he left his legal profession under the call of Gandhiji's non-cooperation movement. It was Motilal Nehru, who also was an eminent lawyer of Allahabad High Court. Father of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, Motilal Nehru was an eminent lawyer of Allahabad High Court. It was Deshbandhu Chittaranjan Das, who was an eminent lawyer of Calcutta High Court. Both of them established the Swaraj Party. And finally, Swaraj Party dedicated a lot for the cause of country's upliftment and brought a remarkable change in the system of administration by making the Britishers agree to provide the facility for the Indian people. And ultimately what happened to them? Swaraj Party agreed with Gandhiji that they would strive towards Hindu-Muslim unity, promote Khadi through spinning and weaving, work for the abolition of untouchability. The Swarajis came to be known as the pro-changers because they also strongly supported Gandhiji's policy of boycott, Gandhiji's policy of non-cooperation movement, Gandhiji's policy of removing untouchability from the grassroots level of the society. Dr. Rajendra Prasad, Dr. Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel, Dr. Ansari, they all joined that movement. They also joined the program and they were known as, and that's why they were known as no changers. Why? Because the rise of socialism helped, brought a new change in the system of administration of the Britishers. They set up chairmanship of Pandit Nehru. Why? Because the revival of revolutionary agitation. Pandit Nehru realized that the concept of socialism, which was started in Soviet Russia after the end of the Tsarist rule, that wave also reached India. And they stressed on the concept of socialism in India, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru and Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. They favored the large-scale industry instead of small-scale industry. They did not strongly support the stand of Mahatma Gandhi because Mahatma Gandhi favored small-scale industry, but they favored large-scale industry. They favored establishment of a number of industries and factories so that many people would get job there. But Gandhi strongly protested it because he wanted to allow the Indian artisans and Indian artisan and craftsmen to earn money from Swadeshi products. Swadeshi products was nothing but the symbol of Indian nationalism. Gandhiji tried to make them understand it. Ultimately, what happened? A number of Indian political parties were set up. Hindustan Socialist Republican Agitation Association was set up. Chandrasekhar Azad took over the association. A number of political freedom fighters, you know, they came forward in support of their agenda, in support of their programs. Meanwhile, Simon Commission was sent to India. Simon Commission came to India with a view to break the deadlocks of the Indian with the Indian leaders, and they wanted to give certain reforms in the structure of the administration. But several leaders came from England. They all were the Britishers. No Indian was included in the team of Simon Commission. So the commission which was sent to India in 1927, that commission was greeted with black flag and demonstrations by uttering the slogan, "Simon go back, Simon go back." Why? Because no Indian member was included in the Simon Commission. The people of India felt insulted and they boycotted the Simon Commission. And then a report was signed by the Nehru, but this point is not included in your syllabus. Nehru report is not there in the as per the reduced syllabus of the council. So next day, some points also are left. I shall discuss it. in detailed form during my revision class, that is the civil disobedience movement as part the reduced syllabus of the council. Up to this, my dear students, thank you.